Hey, Peace Collective. This is Candence Green. I'm coming at you on Saturday morning. The sun is beaming. That rain that came yesterday is gone, and it took with it the heat, the humidity. It's a gorgeous morning, and the breeze is nice and cool. And so I know that this is just another example of God's greatness. It's just beautiful out here. I'm still in New York, still in my mother-in-law's backyard. I'll be here for a couple of more days and then going back home. But I just want to say thank you again this morning. Thank you so much for your for following this series, our Inhale Peace, a 31-day journey to realign with God's peace. We are now on day 7. Today is day 7. Can you believe it? The first week is just flying by. But we've had a really, really good time going through the first 6 days of this series. And I do hope that the messages are resonating with you, that they are relevant, that they are helpful, that those that need to hear these messages are hearing them, and that God is moving throughout it all. And so I just want to say thank you also to some folks who've been purchasing the book this week. And just so you know, Jahan, Lania, Carla, Denise, Janelle, Michelle, and Garfield, your books are in the mail and on their way to you. You should have received an email confirmation from me yesterday with your tracking number. So thank you so much. I tried to get them in the mail as soon as possible, so you would be able to follow along with us with Inhale Peace. All right, so this morning we're on day 7, which is on page 26. We're talking about God's peace, but I'll stress what our topic for today is in just a minute. I want us to kind of just settle our spirits and align with each other, so we're going to do our peace break. It's a Saturday morning, self-care Saturday, but peace breaks are still very necessary. So let's close our eyes and we're going to inhale peace and exhale fear. Inhale peace and exhale stress. Inhale peace. And exhale any worry and anxiety. Lord, we welcome you into this space. Holy Spirit, have your way. Lord, speak through me the things that the people who are watching this need to hear. Let your gentle, marvelous presence be felt in the homes of every person watching this, their cars, their work spaces, wherever they may be. God, we say thank you right now. In Jesus' name do we pray. Amen. All right, so again, I'm in the middle of the city, close to the airport, so you are going to hear some background noises. I'm back in the backyard today, so street noises won't be as loud, but you will hear some airplanes going about because they do live close to the airport. All right, so flip to your in your books to page 26. The scripture for today comes from Psalm 34:14. Seek peace and pursue it. Seek peace and pursue it. Now, I know many of you have spent the week with family, or you spent part of your week with family for the holiday. And sometimes family can stress you out, frustrate you, take you out of your peace zone, and pull you back into the old person that you used to be. But God says to seek peace and pursue it. So if you are understanding that, then you know the enemy likes to come to kill, steal, and destroy your peace, as it says in John 10:10. But we have been suited up in the armor of God, and we know that God will protect us from the enemy who tries to take our peace. But it is an active participation that is going to get you through. Like we said the other day, peace and pursuing it is not an act of a passive act. It's an act of aggression. It is a consistent pursuance that you must pursue God's peace consistently, actively, all the time, making the choice to be at peace. This particular session from this day, day seven, talks about how you can combat the enemy when the enemy comes to steal, kill, and destroy your peace. One great tactic is to internalize scripture. The word of God is the sword, as it says in Ephesians, when we're talking about getting suited up in the armor of God. The word of God is a sword that slices through what the enemy tries to tell you, not only here, but through people. And so memorizing scripture is that one of the best ways to combat the enemy. Place scriptures around you that help you to address those things that are trying to take your peace. According to Ephesians 6:17, the word of God is the sword of the spirit that we can use to combat the enemy's plans. Just said that. So when you memorize that scripture, then you internalize it. And once you internalize it, you begin to speak it. You begin to speak the word of God, which is powerful. Because when you notice and recognize the enemy coming, you stop the enemy in his tracks by speaking God's word to that enemy. Number three says, once you've internalized those scriptures, you place them around your space, speak the word of God to those things that are trying to take your peace. The power of life and death is in your tongue. And you speak life when the enemy is trying to push you toward negativity. Speak that word back to the enemy. You speak it back to the enemy, and that will stop the plan right there. It's like when you start speaking the word of God, it pulverizes the enemy's plan, because then he's like, wait, not only are you still at peace in the midst of this chaos, you're speaking God's word back to me, that I must bow at the word of God, that the name of Jesus, every knee, everything must bow and take a knee when you speak the word Jesus and you speak the word of God. Even the enemy will leave you alone. And one thing to center you, we've been talking about it, your peace breaks. It's your meditative time. It is your time with God. It is your time to talk to God, to tell God what your burdens are. What is it that's holding you down? What is it? What is the weight that's trying to take you out of your peace? What is that moment, that issue, that circumstance, that experience that keeps coming back to you that's taking you out of your peace? God will not only show you the root cause of what is taking you out of your peace, but he will remove it, uproot it. God is the master gardener who will come into your spirit garden and pull the things out that are choking the life out of your peace. Okay? So the thing you must do is talk to God and be honest with him. Tell him, you know what? I can't deal with this. I can't deal with this. God, I don't know what to do with this. Please remove it from my life. Whatever the toxicity is, who are the toxic people? What are my toxic habits? What are the things I'm doing that are causing me to lose my peace? What are the things I'm allowing into my life that are causing me to lose my peace? What are the things that can be removed as an airplane from my life that are causing me to lose my peace? God will come right in. First of all, the Holy Spirit will show you. Then God will come right in and take it out. Take it out. And don't fight him when he takes it out. Don't fight for your toxic thing when God removes it. Don't fight to get it back in your life. And don't turn back to it. Because that, in and of itself, is you releasing and surrendering to God. Because you've given it to him. And so once you give him full reign in your life to reorder your peace, let him do it. Speak the word of God. Read the word. Internalize the word of God. Speak the word of God and connect with God. Abide with God. Commune with God through prayer and through your peace breaks. That's how you maintain the peace of God daily. It is a daily habit. It is a moment by moment habit sometimes. It is a consistent relationship that you are building with the Lord. In that consistent contact, reading God's word, internalizing God's word, speaking God's word, communing and abiding with the Lord is going to keep you in your peace zone. This is it right here. This is where you want to be, right here. You're not on 10. You're not indifferent. You are consistent right here, the peace of God. I hope this message resonates with you on this Saturday morning. Please make some time for self-care. Self-care is not selfish. It is balance, and it is biblical. Balance is biblical, yes. It's not grind, 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 grind all the time. It is work and rest, work and rest. You cannot be fully present. You cannot work at your optimum peak if you are exhausted. So make some time today to rest, whatever that means for you. Whatever rest and self-care means for you, then take advantage of it today. I hope you share this with your family and friends. And if you do not have a copy of the Peace Break card, head over to my website, cherishedflight.com, click on Peace Breaks, and you can download the PDF from there. It's free, and it's there for you to download. And if you don't have a copy of the book, go to my website again, cherishedflight.com, click on CF Shop, or you can wait for that pop-up window to come up, and you just click on that to purchase the book. Last but not least, if you have not been able to follow us this week, but you want to catch up on days 1 through 6, all you have to do again is go to my website, cherishflight.com, and click on Inhale Peace Journey Through the Devotional, and you can watch all of the videos that are there. Number 7 should be up shortly, a little later this morning. I hope you all have an amazing weekend. Have an amazing day. Take advantage of this time, if you do have it, to rest and relax and abide and commune with God. Enjoy yourself. Enjoy the moment. Enjoy the moment. All right. I'll see you tomorrow morning, and may the peace of God settle into your spirit. Peace, everybody.